G'day viewers and welcome to another Onside SA Soccer Show. Paul and Gavin are still away and joining me shortly from his UK studio, Stevie Bram, where we'll be going through the midweek football and obviously discussing the weekend activities. But we kick off as always with our Postnet last one standing competition, and heading into round 9 we had 19 entries. 4 were successful on Fulham, 4 on Notts Forest, while 10 on Brighton and 1 on Aston Villa went out. The guys that were on Fulham are Mark Curry, Francois Dumy from Mauritius, Gary Grant, who is in Ireland, and Fulham's staunch supporter and season ticket holder, Kevin Power. The 4 guys on Notts Forest were Colin McCabe, James Goodman, Mark Jackson, and Sean Phillips. Unfortunately, our 2 ladies went out, but they returned this weekend to play for the 1,000-rand voucher, and they are Sue Miller and Tennille Verners. Guys, the first game is 1:30 SA time, so 12 o'clock is deadline. We're now going to cross over to our UK correspondent in his Fulham studio. Steve, good morning.
Morning, Budge.
Okay, I must say, Steve, we were discussing early show relegation battle. Did you think Fulham would be involved?
Well, at the beginning of the season, yes, I certainly did. But I guess in our own way, we are involved because, you know, we're playing teams around the bottom. And obviously, having sort of beaten Leeds and Forest not that long ago, you know, Leicester came to visit on Monday and I was pleasantly surprised how easily we beat them.
Yeah, well, the 4 guys, last one standing, never had a... Even though the penalty that Vardy missed, but it could have been 7 or 8. And I was really disappointed in Leicester. We'll get to that later. Steve, Champions League, good game Tuesday night. Real Madrid 1, Man City 1. What do you think of the game?
Yeah, really good game. It was sort of cat and mouse in the early stages. Yeah. City had a lot of the ball without that cutting edge. And you just sort of wondered. And, you know, the Madrid crowd were getting a bit frustrated. And all of a sudden, you know, they broke. And that goal, you know, that goal from Vinicius Junior was exceptional. It was like an exocet. No way Edison was going to stop that. And early second half, you know, they started to put City under pressure. But, you know, fantastic equaliser from De Bruyne. Yeah. And in the end, probably, you know, honours even. And it's all set up as effectively, you know, one-off game at the Etihad next week.
Yeah, what was noticeable to me, Steve, was the way Guardiola he didn't go for the victory. He just said, well, okay, 1-1, we're back in the game. Now let's stay 1-1, let's not give anything away. We go back to the Etihad. And I think they'll go through, Steve. I think they're a better team at home with a crowd behind them. You know, I know Real Madrid are dangerous, but other than Vinicius Jr. on the left-hand side, I think they're fairly limited. How do you see it, though?
Yeah, I agree. It's interesting. He didn't bring any subs on.
Yeah.
And it was a pretty warm evening. But I think you're right. I think he knows how dangerous Madrid could be. So if he started throwing players forward, they could get caught on the break. So, understandably, you know, he thinks, look, the game is only half-time. He's not going to throw once or three, like he did last season when City got caught out with those 2 late goals. So, look, you know, Madrid are a dangerous side and you can never rule them out. So I think it's going to be all teed up to be a wonderful game. And, I still think the winner of the competition will come from the winners of that game. But, remains to be seen.
Yeah, I watched the Inter Milan, AC Milan game. One-way traffic, Steve, especially the first half. That penalty, it was interesting on our side. I don't know who he had in your studio, but we had Steve Gerrard and I think it was Peter Crouch. And they both thought it was a penalty and I thought it was a penalty too, to overturn that. Maybe it was 2-0 early on in the game, Salvation Army job, but I found that strange that he overturned it. How did you see that?
Yeah, absolutely. So obviously the Champions League is covered by BT Sport here.
Okay.
So we had people like Rio Ferdinand, Michael Owen.
Okay.
Generally, I think when it was given, they thought it was a penalty. I think 1 or 2 pundits afterwards thought it was a bit soft because he did sort of go down.
Yeah, he was looking for
easily,
it.
But he was touched, and it has to be a clear and obvious error.
Yeah.
And the fact that he was touched by Simon Kjaer, I think it was a brave decision to overturn it.
Yeah.
And that really could have ended the tie because at that stage they were so on top. AC Milan just never got going. And yeah. I know they had, obviously without Liao and Benacer went off injured, but yeah. it was, considering it's, they know each other well, tight games normally between them, that could have been 3, 4 or 5 easily in that first half and the tie would have been done. But, I think Inter will go through now, but they'd probably be kicking themselves. They missed some chances. They could have had it totally wrapped up. But, interesting, Lukaku on the bench playing Dzeko at 37, scored a great goal. Mkhitaryan at 34.
Very experienced.
Very experienced.
Yeah, I've watched some, because obviously we've had a few bets, and I've watched AC Milan and Inter. Inter, in my opinion, are way ahead of AC. When Giroud's still playing, with all due respect to him, and you look around the build-up play, they haven't got much AC Milan. Their league form is woeful. And I was confident Inter Milan would win. But obviously, being a two-legged game, you think it'll be tight. But after 20 minutes, it was only one result. Steve, on to tonight, we got some Europa League. The first one I'm interested in is Juventus-Seville. I was going to back Juventus to win it when United were in it, because I wasn't a fancy or favourite of Man United. I fancy them tonight, Steve. How do you see it going there?
Yeah, look, I mean, this is will be a really good game at, over the two legs. I think Juventus will probably start as favourites. They're showing, obviously, they've got, they seem to be sort of buoyed by the fact they got their 15 points back.
Yeah.
But Seville, look how dangerous they are, the way they played against United. So you can never rule them out. I think that Juventus are definitely going to want to take a lead to Seville. And I think if they do, that they probably see it through.
Yeah.
But I think that for me, that's the tie of the two. I think that's the one I'm going to enjoy watching.
Yeah. Jose Mourinho in charge at Roma. Couldn't believe what he did against Inter Milan on Sunday. I watched the first half. He rested about 6 of his better players. They got beat 2-0. He's lumped all his eggs into this trophy, Stephen. Xabi Alonso, I know, is the flavour of the month in England. I think Spurs want him. But Bayer Leverkusen can attack, but they can't defend. I think Rome will end up going through. How do you see it, though?
Yeah, I agree. I was surprised that he obviously realises, Mourinho, that they've blown their chances of Champions League place.
Yeah.
But in fact, they're pretty much almost out of all the European places. Their form has sort of fallen away so much. When a few weeks ago they were looking as if they could get fourth spot. But you're right. I think they will start as favourites. And I think you're right about Bayer Leverkusen. I mean, they're not setting the world alight in the Bundesliga.
No.
I think Roma will take a lead there and defend it. So, and you could end up with an all-Italian final, which should be interesting.
Yeah, I watched Bayer Leverkusen play the Belgian team Union Saint-Gilloise. It was 3-3 in Bayer. It was a superb game, but obviously the second leg, they didn't make the defensive mistakes. But you never know with these German teams. They're enthusiastic. They have a go. But I think it'll be a cracker. Steve, West Ham, after their outclassed Man United on Sunday, should they be too good against AZ Alkmaar?
Well, I think they'll win. AZ Alkmaar are not a bad side, but I think West Ham have got, now that they're pretty comfortable in the league, a crazy set of results. I mean, they're pretty safe. And I think that he can play his strongest team and again next week. And I think that they'll want to take a lead with them. But I think over the two legs, West Ham should be too strong.
Yeah, the other task, Fiorentina against FC Basel. I was going to back Fiorentina as a knockout rounds. I just saw, you never know with these Italian teams away from home. But they were lucky in the last round, Steve. They were 3-0 down at home against Lech Poznan and came back to win. But I think they'll be too good for the Swiss team. Do you agree?
Yeah, I think they will. Yes, I think so. I think that it's interesting how well the Italian teams have done in Europe this season.
Yeah.
Having not really shown much in recent years. And I think that Fiorentina-West Ham would be a good final.
Yeah, Fiorentina-West Ham and the Italians to meet in the Europa League. Steve, that's your call.
Yeah, and Inter to play City.
Okay. Well, that's true. Fortunately, Man United fans have something to watch if it is the final, because Lukaku, is it Darmian and Mkhitaryan all played for United. I think we won the Europa League, so hopefully lightning strikes twice. Anyway, Steve, on to the Premiership for the weekend and lunchtime kickoff games don't get much bigger than this. Leeds United versus Newcastle United. How do you see it?
Well, I mean, obviously, you know, we've spoken a lot last week about Big Sam coming in. That first hour, I don't think it made much difference away at City. I mean, City, to be fair, like, Pep rested one or two. You know, they once they went ahead, you couldn't see any other result. Obviously, we know that Pep was not very happy about the penalty situation.
Yeah.
You know, he was furious that Haaland didn't take it and kill the game. And then, obviously, as often with these things, Leeds made them pay with a goal. But really, City never really got out of sort of second gear, I don't think, for most of the game. Leeds, look, this is a huge game for them. I mean, they can't afford to lose. But on the other hand, Newcastle aren't going to want to throw away a top four place. So I think if Leeds got anything out of the game, would be a surprise, and Newcastle rightly start as favourites.
Yeah, I think there'll be plenty of goals. Second half, I think it'll open up. So I saw both teams to score in the second half at 18 to 10, but I think there'll be goals in this, Steve. Wouldn't surprise me if it's 3-1, 4-2, because they've both got to go for it. But Newcastle, 7 to 10, inviting price. Aston Villa, Tottenham, Steve, this is a big game. Pity you haven't got Paul here just to see what he fancies. But I fancy Villa are the two sides, Steve. I know you don't. But, you know, last five home games, they've won five, haven't conceded a goal. I think Spurs will score, but they've got a lot of pace and attack, and Spurs are a bit woeful at the back, Steve. I'm all over Villa. Give me a reason why you fancy Spurs.
Well, I mean, I think Villa have not played at all well the last couple of games.
Yeah.
Relatively poor performances, losing both, not scoring. I thought against Fulham the week before, the second half, they were very poor, quite happy to sit back. I just think that for Tottenham, this is not, if Tottenham want to get into a Europa place, this is almost do or die for them. They need to go there and get a result. They've got the players to do it, whether or not, you know, and they battled their way to a win last week, you know, battled their way to get three second half goals at Liverpool. I just think the odds are against them, but I just got a feeling this is one of those Tottenham games that they just pull something out of the bag. And if they lose, then, you know, Europa is Europa League, at the very least, has gone for them. So I think it'll be a good game. You know, they invariably are. Tottenham got a good record against Villa away. And I just got a feeling they might just surprise the odds and get a result up there.
Yeah, I think the goals are gain here. You know, two sides that are better going forward than in defence. But, I could see it going Tottenham's way, Steve. But away from home, they haven't won in six. I think it's 16 goals they've conceded. Now, for me, I'm siding with Villa. The next game, Steve, Chelsea. You know, I watched a bit of the Chelsea-Bournemouth game. Bournemouth had two chances at 1-1 to go ahead. And then Chelsea end up scoring too late. I've been impressed with Forrest, Steve. I thought they were superb on Monday night against Southampton, even though it was Southampton who scored last-minute goal. But I think Forrest can cause trouble here. How do you see it going, though?
Well, I think Forrest are going to look at that league table and think if they've got any type of result at Chelsea, it gives them a real opportunity to pull away. On the other hand, you know, I keep thinking Chelsea, before the game at Bournemouth, I'm thinking they've got to turn the corner. Maybe getting that win, that might just give them that little bit of confidence that they need. And I just think Forest away are pretty poor. I mean, they did put up a fight at Liverpool, they put up a fight at Brentford, but they have got by far the worst away record.
Yes.
I wonder whether they'll go there and think, try and shut up shop and get a point, which might not be the best tactic. I just think that Chelsea will edge a home win here. Not satisfactory necessarily for them, but Forest, I think, have still got an opportunity to get. I think Forest might only need another point. And I think not sure they'll get it on the weekend, though.
Yeah, I think they'll score, Steve. I saw 7-10. I just like what they've got going forward. You know, and they've got a lot of fight in them. You know, you say that Liverpool's 3-2. The first half was all Liverpool. But Liverpool scored, then they fought back 2-1, 2-all. And even against Brentford last week. You know, the week before, I was impressed with their fight, Steve. They're not giving in. And that's what gives me a chance at, I think they could maybe sneak a point. You know, Chelsea have only won one in, was it eight? And they could have lost that either. I know they've got all the talent in the world, and I agree. You know, imagine on training, you go in there, we've had a victory, we got the bonus, and everyone will be bubbling. But I know they start short favourites, but, you know, I'd be a little bit wary of that. But I think Forest will score at 7-10. That's my play. Steve, I've hummed and hawed about the Crystal Palace-Bournemouth game. I've been impressed with the job that Roy Hodgson's done. But Bournemouth, they fought hard. You know, they were unlucky last week. You know, and some of the exotics have chanced Crystal Palace, but I don't know, how do you see this one going? This has got me confused.
Yeah, I mean, look, both teams are safe. Hopefully it's an entertaining game because they don't need to be cautious. I think Palace will edge this one. I just think at home, Roy's, you know, as you say, has dragged them up from a dangerous position when he came in, and they're totally safe now. And I just think I think that they've got the players to do it. A little bit disappointing last weekend, but I think that they've got the players to get the result at the weekend.
Yeah, just, you know, Bournemouth are one of those funny teams, Steve. You know, you think they're going to get a good hiding and then they burgle a goal. And, you know, they did it. I remember when they did they draw, they just get beat at Newcastle. But the fight they showed, I thought, this manager's got something. But any results possible for me here, even though I've had to side with Palace in one or two of our bets. Steve, Man United, I thought they're unlucky against Brighton. What Luke Shaw did was criminal. But against West Ham, they never turned up. If ever there's a game, they have to win. It's this game at home against Wolves. Can you see them doing it?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, the game at Brighton, they had enough chances early on.
Yeah.
And to give, I mean, Luke Shaw's such an experienced player, to give that penalty away was crazy. And as you say, they didn't play at all well. They never really got going at West Ham. Had one or two early chances, but otherwise will be. And I think, look, Wolves last time out away conceded six at Brighton. You think that they're going to, you know, they're obviously a lot tighter last weekend. I think United will win this. I think they're going to look at the fixtures, look at around them. They need these points. They can't afford to drop points because, you know, with Liverpool on their coattails. So I think United will, you know, the FA Cup final is not for a few weeks. He should play a strong, debatable team. And I think that they'll get the result. I think they'll win by a couple of goals.
Oh, let's hope so. You know, last 12 home league games, 10 wins and 2 draws. And if it wasn't for the home form, they'd be nowhere. Steve, on to our next page. Your boys, Fulham, at Southampton. My opinion, you know, I've been impressed the last few weeks since your main man up front, Mitrovic. Is he coming back this weekend? Is
he? Well, he's available. He's available. I'm not sure whether or not they will automatically put him in, because Carlos Vinicius, to be fair to him, has scored in our last two home games.
Yeah.
And actually, it's taken them a long time, but he's just starting to show a little bit more sort of form. Having said that, he isn't Mitrovic. You know, we don't know how fresh Mitrovic is.
Yeah.
Obviously, he's not been playing for the last 8 games, but, you know, he's probably chomping at the bit.
Yeah.
I mean, Southampton is do or die for them. If they don't win, they're automatically relegated. And even if they win, they're pretty much still favourites to go down.
Yeah.
I think it would be an entertaining game. There's definitely going to be goals. I mean, we don't keep clean sheets, as nor does Southampton. You know, we don't need to be cautious. We can have a real go and play, you know, as we did at against Leicester. And I think, you know, I think there could be sort of 4, 5, 6 goals in this game.
Yeah.
I think it will be close. I think we're capable of winning it, but even a draw isn't enough for Southampton. So it should be a good game.
Yeah, I'll make Fulham each way bet 15 to 10. I think it's a great price. The other bet which I had on Monday night was James Ward-Prowse to score. It was 7 to 2 on Monday. It's the same price again, because you know they'll get a set piece around the box. That's how they play, and he's dead out, Dick. Next game, Brentford-West Ham, Steve. Brentford, my UK best bet of the weekend. Simple reason. West Ham, that result against United almost guarantees them, bar a miracle, a premiership place. He's not going to play one senior player. And if ever there's a game the fans will let him get beaten, it's this one. And, you know, we know Brentford's home form, Steve. Only Newcastle have beat them at home in the last 13. I'm all over 11 to 10 Brentford, Steve. How do you see it?
Yeah, no, absolutely agree. I think you're right. I think David Moyes isn't going to want to take any chances with his key players.
Yeah.
You know, they are safe mathematically. You know, it's such a go, but I mean, mathematically, you know, they look at that league table. No one's going to go down this season with the points they've got.
Yeah.
And as you say, I mean, it's interesting when they played in the FA Cup at Brentford.
Yeah.
Moyes, because they were doing bad in the league, he put out a very strong team and they deservedly won. But I think the other way around, I think he will rest a few. I can't see the point in risking all of his top players, because if it's tight tonight, they're not going to want to risk any of those players going over to Holland. So
yeah.
I think you know, it's an opportunity for Brentford to win, and I agree with you. I think that's a good bet for the week this week.
Yeah, and also for Moyes to give, he must have several players on the bench, give them a game, so that'll keep them happy. But 11 to 10 for me all day. Steve, Everton, result of the season, didn't see that coming. But Man City, you know, if they'd been playing on Tuesday, the second leg, I think it may be a little bit different. But because the game's on Wednesday, it gives them a few more days. I fancy Everton to be competitive. I don't see them getting beat 4 or 5. I think they'll score, Steve. But Man City on current form, they've won their last 10. You know, you've got to expect them to make it 11.
Yeah, I think so. Look, I suspect he will rotate a little bit, as he did against Leeds.
Yeah.
I mean, he started with Haaland. You know, he may well play Foden or Mahrez.
Yeah.
You know, which it's not exactly weakened them, yeah. But you know, I wouldn't be at all surprised if he does that. Look, Everton will be buoyed by that. It was an incredible result. They're going to have a go. They've got nothing to lose because, you know, there are other games that they can get points.
Yes.
So it's a bit of a free hit for them. I don't think they'll, you know, but on the other hand, Sean Dyche might say, you know what, 10 behind the ball the whole game and let's see what happens. I think it will be close. I'd be very surprised if there's even more than a goal in it. I think Pep would be very happy to win by a goal and just keep the juggernaut going. Obviously, he's conscious of the fact that Arsenal got a big result last weekend, so it's not quite done and dusted yet. So I think, you know, they need to get that result, City, and I think they will. But it will be very, I think it will be close.
Yeah, I think he will. I think he will make changes. You've got to keep Haaland fresh, unless he does what he normally does, play him the first half. But Everton are going to kick lumps out of them, Steve. So I think he's going to be mindful, you know, of a few players. But I agree, he's got to give Foden and a few of the game, Mahrez in the mid. But I'm all over Everton. I think they'll score. I don't see them winning, but I think it was 7-8 to 10 them to score. So that's my play there. Arsenal, Brighton, Steve. Big game for the Gunners. I thought they played well at stages against Newcastle, but they got fortunate. They hit the post a couple of times, Newcastle.
Yeah.
And if it had gone 1-1 all, then we would have seen what would have happened to them. But Brighton really, really disappointed in Monday's performance. But I expect them to bounce back, Steve, but I still fancy Arsenal.
Yeah, I mean, look, Arteta knows they can't afford to drop any points at all because City won't be dropping many. I think, you know, you're right. I think Brighton can't play as badly as that again. But, you know, they've had two big defeats, losing at Forest and losing at Everton. Matches,
yeah.
I think most people thought they'd get results. I think Arsenal are going to be all over them early on. And I think they'll score the goals and win the game.
Yeah.
You know, it's possible that the fact that Brighton have now got quite a few games still to play compared to everybody else. But it might just catch up with them a bit. They've got one or two injuries.
Yeah.
You know, I think it'll be a good game. But I just think if Arsenal have any aspirations to still, you know, win the league, they have to go all out and win this game.
Yeah, no, I agree. Especially at the Emirates, yeah, two results, and especially if Man City slip up, you know, they'll be buoyed. But I agree, Arsenal 7-10 do look good things. And last but not least, Steve, I can't believe Liverpool are 6-10 to win at Leicester. What I saw. I know Fulham destroyed them, and if they give Liverpool those chances, it's going to be another 5 or 6. How do you see it, though?
Well, I mean, it's interesting. I don't know if you saw James Maddison's interview after the game. I mean, he was genuinely upset, and couldn't believe how badly they played and badly they defended. And he admitted there was just not enough fight in the team, which is worrying, you know, for their fans going into the last three games.
Yeah.
Look, I think Liverpool will win this. I think Leicester will give them a tougher game than I think that they gave Fulham, only because, you know, I think they have to. You know, you'd assume they've had the riot act read to them.
Yeah.
And, you know, the players, for sheer pride, are going to want to put in a better performance. But, you know, Liverpool will cut through that defence. I mean, you know, the fact that Fulham scored 5 and could have had more, you'd expect that sort of Salah and Nunes and, you know, Jota to be ripping through them. And I think even if Leicester score 1 or 2, I don't think they'll be anywhere near enough. So, you know, I can see Liverpool scoring 3 or 4 and, you know, be a nail in Leicester's coffin because they are struggling at the moment.
Yeah, Liverpool to score over 2.5 goals, I saw 12-10. I thought that was a gift. I think this is going to be another high-scoring game. Liverpool 6 wins in a row, and this should be 7. Steve, there's a couple of markets that I saw this morning. Top 4 finish. Newcastle, Man United, Liverpool. Which 2 of the 3 have you got?
I'm still going with Newcastle and United.
Okay.
You know, but they can't afford to slip up. Liverpool are on their coattails, and you know they keep winning. It puts pressure. I mean, they've caught up a lot in the last few weeks, as you say, with 6 wins in a row. Look, if you get a crazy result and Leeds beat Newcastle or United slip up to Wolves, then yes, they can be caught. But I think after this weekend, I think it will still be the status quo. I think you still have Newcastle and United will still be clear of Liverpool, but have a game in hand as well.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's the key, I think, for them is they do, even if they slipped up, they do have that one extra game. But I think it's going to be close. Liverpool are going to push them, and for me, they'll finish fifth.
Okay. Who finishes sixth, Brighton or Spurs?
Well, listen, a week or so ago, you would have said Brighton, but, yeah. You know, losing to Forest, losing to Everton, they've still got to play against Arsenal and City. I just think it's almost in Tottenham's hands, because I think Brighton will drop points. They've got games in hand, but they're not always an advantage when you get to the end of the season. Players are tired and they're playing, you know, sort of Saturday, Wednesday or whatever. I think if Brighton slip up and Tottenham get that result at Villa, I think that it could be Tottenham to get that sixth place.
Yeah, 12 to 10 Tottenham, worth an interest. But this weekend's a big one. And Steve, last but not least, the relegation odds. You've got Southampton are 1 to 100. They're almost certain gone.
Yeah.
You've got Leeds and Leicester to follow suit and go down with them?
I think so now. I think that was a huge result for Everton and for Forest. I think if either would have slipped up, would have kept them right down there. But, you know, with the fixtures that both Leeds and Leicester have got, barring a real surprise, you can see the two of them joining Southampton.
Yeah, Leeds have Newcastle, West Ham and Spurs, and Leicester have Liverpool, Newcastle and West Ham. 3-point gap to Notts Forest. They're going to have to get 4 points, and I don't see it, so I agree with Steve. Steve, on to the Championship. It's playoffs. You know, I love the Championship. The prices are great, even though the results are inconsistent. But playoff Saturday, we've got it in all our pools. Sunderland hosting Luton Town. How do you see it?
Yeah, it's going to be a big game. I mean, look, Sunderland sneaked in right at the end, obviously with Millwall imploding. You know, Millwall had that sixth place sewn up and threw it away in the end. Sunderland came back with a big win at Preston. Yeah. Huge crowd expected, best part of 40,000 at the Stadium of Light. I think they'll roar Sunderland on to victory. Luton, have had a really good season, but I think just got a feeling some of them might think that this is their opportunity, you know, to come up, you know, from last year and get themselves to Wembley. So I just fancy Sunderland to only by a goal, but I think that at the weekend I fancy them.
Yeah, of the two, I like them too. But Luton unbeaten in 14 and unbeaten in 12 away from home. So I think a draw is a player, but I'm hoping for Sunderland. The other game, Steve, cost us a lot of money last week when Middlesbrough drew 1-1 at home with Coventry. This is going to be another tight game, but which way do you see it going?
Yeah, I think it will be a very tight game. You know, so there was nothing to choose between them last weekend. You know, a bit of a dummy run, a trial run, but I think there'll be a little bit more intensity this weekend.
Yeah.
Coventry are going to want to get a result, you know, to go, because Borough are strong at home. I think this could end up all square again.
Okay.
You know, again, expecting a huge crowd. But I just got a feeling Borough will maybe just do enough and take them back to the Riverside. You know, and I'm predicting an all northeast final. I just got this feeling.
It's Middlesbrough, Sunderland,
Sunderland, Middlesbrough. Yeah, it could easily be the others, but I just got this feeling that, you know, Sunderland just no one was expecting them to get that sixth place in the end, and they did. And I just wonder whether or not they're the team who are going to fancy it.
All right, of the four teams, Steve, who've you got coming up?
Well, Borough, for me, I've got the players who can do it. Luton might surprise everybody. I mean, nobody's expected Luton to be up there again. I just wonder whether or not the occasion will get to them. You know, it could be. I mean, all four, you know, none of those four teams, you know, the top two have been the top two for a long time and walked away with it. You know, there isn't a lot to choose between 3, 4, 5 and 6. You know, so it really is anyone's call. You know, and I think that's good, because, you know, in the past, sometimes you get a team that's finished third, only just missed out, and they're clear favourites. But I think here, you know, you can make an argument for any of them. So, you know, they're always big games, and, you know, the playoff, the final at Wembley, as I say, it's the richest game in world football.
Yeah.
So for what it means, you know, the money that they get for going up. So you can imagine, I mean, look, Luton, with their capacity of 10,000, you know, virtually, you know, hardly spent any money at all. I mean, it's a game changer for them.
Yeah. Strange. Weren't they the first team that had the plastic pitch, or was that QPR?
Luton and Oldham, but I can't remember who of the three had it first, but it could have been Luton. And then it was Oldham and QPR. And in those days, it made a huge difference.
Yeah, like tennis courts.
I remember going to see Fulham play at QPR on the plastic pitch, and we were three down at half-time until we got used to the bounce, and then we played a lot better second half. We still lost, but unless they trained on it, they really could have found it hard to get used to that bounce.
Steve, pressure time again, please. I need your value bet or your best bet and value bet. Who are you going for?
Interesting enough, I think we've gone for the same best bet again. I'm going for Brentford.
Okay.
I just think that, I just got this feeling. If West Ham needed points to stay up, it would be different. But I think you're right. I think David Moyes, why wouldn't he? He'll rest players. And my value bet, I'm just going to go for Tottenham. I just think, they can see a chink of light with Brighton slipping up a little bit. And I just think that they'll put in a big performance and win at Villa.
Yeah, I agree. I'm on Brentford, UK. Osasuna's my best bet of the weekend in Spain, Steve. They're unlucky to lose the Copa del Rey to Real Madrid last weekend. They're a good team at home against a mediocre team. And I think the bookies are reacting to that defeat. I've watched them. They're not a bad team at 11-10. I think they're good things this weekend. But as far as the Premiership goes, I just think West Ham, their fans will accept it. This is going to be a 2-3-0 job for me. Steve? Thanks again. Look after yourself and we'll speak over the weekend.
Absolutely. Cheers, Budge.
All the best, Steve. So, UK correspondent Stevie Braham. We had a couple of Confederations Cup yesterday. Unfortunately, my mate Dylan Kerr's side conceded too late when they got beat by Young Africans of Tanzania. The second leg's next Wednesday. Difficult task, but they score early. Anything is possible. We now go on to our PSL fixtures of the week. And we kick off in Cape Town. All the games are the same time. 3 o'clock on Saturday. And the first game up, we've got Cape Town City versus Richards Bay. I think Cape Town City are absolute certainties. I know they've drawn their last three at home. But Richards Bay have taken 1 point from the last 10. And that was against Maritzburg United or in Dire Straits. 8-10 has had my money. Golden Arrows, AmaZulu, local derby. You just never know with AmaZulu. Their form is bad. They've only won 1-6 and one away from home. Golden Arrows, you never know. Last week, they got a great result in Cape Town. I think there'll be goals in this. I saw 12-10, both teams to score. Of the two sides, I like Golden Arrows. This is make or break for Maritzburg. They tossed a 2-2 draw at Maruma Gallets conceding late, and they 3 points adrift at the bottom. Stellenbosch unfortunately got beat on penalties in the Nedbank Cup. But Steve Barker's done a good job, but I don't see any slackness in his team. Got a fancy Maritzburg of the two sides, but I'd rather take 12-10 both teams to score than 13-10 Maritzburg, as much as I want the KZN team to win. Orlando Pirates, Sekakuna. This is a final of the Nedbank Cup in a couple of weeks' time. Orlando Pirates in great form, 1-6 and drawn 1. The only teams that have beaten them at late have been Sundowns, who beat them 1-0 at home, and Kaiser Chiefs, who they beat in the Cup on the weekend. Sekakuna done great. They are in a decent place, but their last five away from home, they've only got 1 point, and they haven't scored a goal, so you've got to fancy the Buccaneers in that clash. Onto our second page, we've got Royal AM against Swallows. Royal AM at Chatsworth Stadium, hard to beat. They did get beat the last time there, but that was in the bucketing rain when they played Cape Town City. Morocco Swallows on a bit of a roll. They've won 3 of the last 5 and 3 of the last 4 away from home, but Royal AM at Chatsworth, 13-10, that will have my money. The Supersport Kaiser Chiefs game has been moved. I think they're playing it in the Northwest. Chiefs really unlucky against Pirates last week. They should have had a penalty. Supersport away from home, strangely, haven't won in 7. So the betting looks a little bit skewed there. The bookies are obviously taking, Chiefs to be sulking after last week. But I don't see that. But both teams to score would be my suggestion there. And a game where I think should be a good game. And last but not least, TS Galaxy, you can still drop into the relegation playoff match against Chipper United, who have only won 1 of the last 6. But that was against Richards Bay. They were 2-0 down in Durban and came back to win 3-2. A tight game. I think there'll be goals, but 21-10 the draw is my suggestion. Mamelodi Sundowns aren't playing. They play in the CAF Champions League. They play against Wydad Casablanca. Tough game. But Sundowns, Al Ahly, that looks just nailed on in the final. They did play in the group stage and Sundowns gave them a hiding. But when it comes to the knockout stages, Al Ahly of Egypt are a different team. On to our bets for the weekend. Sorry, our soccer exotics. And we kick off with our score six. I've thrown the drawn with Newcastle United at Leeds United. I've gone the field in the Aston Villa Tottenham Hotspur game. I've thrown the drawn with Chelsea at home against Notts Forest. Crystal Palace Bournemouth, I've gone the field there because I think Man United will beat Wolves and I fancy Fulham to win at Southampton, 216 Rand. On to PSL Soccer 6, I've banked Cape Town City to beat Richards Bay. The field in the Golden Arrows AmaZulu game, I'm going for Orlando Pirates to beat Sekhukhune United. SuperSport United win and draw against Kaizer Chiefs, as long as TS Galaxy win and draw at home against Shipper United. And the field in the CAF Champions League match between Wydad Casablanca and Mamelodi Sundowns, 2-1-6. On to our score 10 for the weekend, I'm banking Newcastle to win at Leeds United. The field in the Aston Villa Tottenham Hotspurs game, I'm going Chelsea win and draw at home against Notts Forest, as well as Crystal Palace win and draw at home against Bournemouth. Man United, I'm hoping get back to winning ways and beat Wolverhampton Wanderers. Our second page, I've got Fulham to win at Southampton. Sunderland win and draw at home against Luton Town. The field in the Spanish clash between Villarreal and Athletic Bilbao. I think Inter Milan will be too strong for Sassuolo. And I've thrown the draw in with the Madrid derby. Getafe are struggling and Real Madrid, I think, will rest all their main players because of the second leg. So I put win and draw Real Madrid, 288. On to our soccer 13 for the weekend. I'm banking Man United to beat Wolves. Aston Villa win and draw at home against Tottenham Hotspur. Chelsea win and draw at home against Nottingham Forest. I've chanced Crystal Palace to win at home against Bournemouth. And I fancy Fulham to win at relegation threat in Southampton. Sunderland win and draw at home against Luton Town. And Barnsley to avoid defeat in the League One playoff at Bolton Wanderers. On to the second page, I'm going Stockport County win and draw at Salford in the League Two playoff. I think Notts County will be too strong for Chesterfield in the promotional National League game. Norrköping too strong for Varbergs Bar and the Swedish Elvenskan. I'm going AC Milan. I'm chancing them, especially after last night's performance, to win at struggling Spezia. And I've gone Real Madrid, win and draw at home against Getafe. And Villarreal, win and draw at home against Athletic Bilbao, 256. On to our Budgies bets for the weekend. I'm going Fulham to beat Southampton, Brentford to beat West Ham, Liverpool to beat Leicester City, and over 3.5 goals. Couldn't believe the price, 3,100 to 200. Our team goals only, I'm going Aston Villa, Crystal Palace and Brentford, all to score over 1.5 goals, and Liverpool to score over 2.5 goals, 3,400 to 200. With limited action, the championship, I've gone over 2.5 goals in both teams to score, yes. In the Leeds, Newcastle, Aston Villa, Tottenham, Chelsea, Notts Forest, and Everton, Man City, 4,000 to 200. I thought that was a great price. On to the PSL, I'm going Cape Town City to beat Richards Bay, Royal AM to beat Swallows, and both teams to score in the Maritzburg Stellenbosch and SuperSport Kaizer Chiefs fixtures, 3,200 to 200. Onto our Spanish La Liga, I'm going for a quartet. I'm going Mallorca to beat Cadiz on Friday, Osasuna to beat Almeria on Saturday, and both teams to score in the Real Madrid Getafe, Real Valladolid Sevilla games, 3,000 to 200. Now, Colas King, six or nixer, worked out at a great price. I'm going Brentford to beat West Ham, Liverpool to beat Leicester City, Lazio to beat Lecce, Napoli to beat AC Monza, Atletico Madrid to beat Elche, and Osasuna to beat Almeria, 5,700 to 200. For the guys in last one standing, please, midday, I need your selection, so they have to get the PDF out. And to everyone else, please remember to stay onside.